Hello friends, welcome to our channel Easy Shorts of Learning. Today we take very interesting topic of accountancy, that is insurance claim, where we learn to calculate the amount of claim for loss of stock which was destroyed by fire at when the gross profit rate is given in question. Now when the fire broke out in any factory, store or shop, then along with the stock, fixed assets are also damaged, such as plant, machinery, furniture. But in case of fixed assets, when the insurance company do insurance, they record them at original cost or purchase price, and after deducting depreciation from the date of purchase to date of fire, the company will get the claim. But in case of loss of stock, the problem arises because the value of stock or quantity of stock keeps on changing, and the stock keeps on moving from store to shop or from store to production department. So it is very difficult for us to calculate the actual value of stock which was present at the time of date of fire. So in case when the when we calculate loss of stock which was protected by fire insurance policy, first we have to see that the stock ledger is maintained by the shopkeeper or store manager, because stock ledger shows the receipt and issue of material or stock. So we easily find out the value of stock and get the claim from the insurance company. But if this stock ledger is destroyed by fire or not maintained by the store manager or shopkeeper, then we have to calculate the value of stock, and afterwards we calculate the amount of claim. So first we understand the example and see what type of questions come in your examination, and then calculate the amount of claim. Here A Limited has taken out a fire insurance policy of 2,40,000 covering stock in trade. It means the value of fire insurance policy is 2,40,000. A fire occurred on 30th June 2021 in the godown of A Limited. Now the date of fire is 30th June 2021. Stock saved from fire amounted to 86,400. It means the godown manager or other people saved the stock amounted to 86,400, and we have to calculate the insurance claim from the following information, which includes stock as on 31st March 2021. It means it is a closing stock for previous year and opening stock for current year, that is the financial year from 1st April 2021 to 31st March 2022. Now the purchases and sales from 1st April to the date of fire, that is 30th June, are 4,48,000, and sales, that is 6,16,000. We have also gross profit rate is given in question, that is 25% on sales, which is based on past year's data. Now first we summarize this question. Here the financial year starts from 1st April 2021 to 31st March 2022, and the date of fire is 30th June 2021. Now the data that we provided by the company, which involves purchases amounted to 4,48,000 and sales 6,16,000, opening stock valued at 3,34,000. In additional information, we have stock saved, policy value and gross profit rate. Now first we have to prepare memorandum trading account to find out the value of stock which was present at the time when the fire broke out in the godown of A Limited. And if we find this stock, that is at the as on 30th June 2021, then we easily calculate the amount of claim for loss of stock. So first we prepared the memorandum trading account to find out the value of stock which was present at that time. And the memorandum trading account is same as the trading account, which involves in debit side all the expenses and on credit side all the incomes. On debit side we have opening stock, purchases, direct wages, carriage inward, and when the gross profit rate is given, then we easily calculate the gross profit, and it is also included in debit side. On credit side we write sales, and the difference amount of total and sales is stock which was present at the time of at the date of fire, or which was present in the godown of A Limited when the fire broke out. So from the following information, that is opening stock is 334,000. So first we write opening stock in memorandum trading account to opening stock, and the value of opening stock is 334,000. Other information includes purchases 448,000 and sales 616,000 from 1st April to date of fire. So we write purchases first on in debit side to purchases, and the amount is 448,000, and our sales from 1st April to date of fire amounted to 616,000. Other data includes we have a gross profit rate, and it is based on sales, that is 25%. So we calculate gross profit on sales. First we write gross profit on debit side. Our sales is 616,000 and gross profit on sales is 25%. So we get the gross profit of 1,54,000 and the total of debit side is 9,36,000. Now we write this total on credit side to find out the value of stock. So first we write this amount, and the balancing value is stock as on 30th June 2021, that is the date of fire, and the stock which was present when the fire broke out in the godown amounted to 320,000. Now we get this stock. Now we calculate the amount of loss of stock from fire. For this, first we deduct the stock saved from the stock value which was present. So our next step is calculation of loss of stock. In this, first we write stock as on date of fire. After that, we deduct the stock saved from this this value, and we will get loss of stock which was destroyed by fire. So first we write stock as on 30th June, that is the date of fire, and stock which was available here, that is 320,000. So we write 320,000 value of stock is present. Now the stock saved from fire amounted to, stock saved is 86,400. So we write 86,400, and we deduct this amount from value of stock which was present, and we get loss of stock which was destroyed by fire, that is 233,600. Now in our last step, we calculate the amount of claim for loss of stock. Here our formula is, first we write the loss of stock which we already calculated in step number 2, then we multiply it with policy value divided by stock as on date of fire. Here loss of stock is 233,600. So first we write 233,600 is our loss of stock. Now according to insurance company, if you take insurance policy for less amount, then you will get the claim in that proportionate only. So your insurance, here the insurance policy value is 240,000, but according to insurance company, you will take the policy your policy valued, that is 320,000, because this is the value of stock which is in your go down at the time when the fire broke out. So your amount of policy will be 320,000, but you take less amount policy so that your premium amount is decreased. So you will get the claim of less amount. So first we write the policy value. You take the policy of 240,000 and you are eligible for policy of 320,000. So you will get the claim in proportionate to that amount, and your amount of claim is 1,75,200. So in case when the gross profit rate is given, first we have to prepare memorandum trading account to find out the value of stock which was destroyed at the time of date of fire, value of stock which was present at the time of date of hire. Then after that, after deducting stock saved from that value of stock, we get loss of stock, and afterwards we calculate amount of claim for loss of stock. So friends, if you like this video, please share this video and subscribe the channel. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.